dito. Okay, so let's begin. Ito, medyo quick review lang tayo. Kasi I've been watching the video of Mark 2 Saturdays ago, if I'm not mistaken. Yung nagpabigay siya ng handouts, is that right? I think meron kayong konting test dun sa goodness, kindness and goodness na shinare niya. So right now, I won't be doing that naman, of course, as a guest here. So rather, gusto ko lang na pasadahan natin to before I even begin. And I know, Big South Alabang is a very studious or malakas ang memoria natin, di ba? So, I'll just run through this. So, first and foremost, the fruit of the Spirit, di ba? You are on your series on Walk Different, Living in the Spirit. So, pasadahan ko lang to before I proceed with my assignment tonight. So, but the fruit of the Spirit is? Okay, so love. Ano ba yan? I think I wasn't able to watch the video, nag-breakdown daw. So, but anyway, Mark opened this series with you when he talked about the introduction of this series. Tama ba? But he alluded to that, yung love, what love is all about. So rather than me trying to recall ko ano yung message niya, which is di ko na nga napanood, so I just want to describe the fruit of the Spirit is actually love in the form of blank, 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 and blank. To follow yung mga yan. So yan, I think your next after Mark, sinundan to ni Joy. I mean, naasawa ni Joy. Okay, di ba? John preached about joy, and I think he clearly shared there with you about joy being not dependent on circumstances, right? Because a happiness that's dun yun, magkakaiba. When you talk about happiness, it would depend on the happenings, rather, on the happenings that happen around you. So tayo, we just have to choose to just enjoy life, or rather, when God is with us, we can just choose to rejoice no matter what. Like this couple right now, kitang-kita ko yung joy sa kanilang dalawa. So I can just stare at them and mapapangiti na rin ako. Okay? And then, I think Noki, where is Noki? Sinundan niya yan with peace and patience. He shared with you, correct me if I'm wrong, you shared about victory over conflicts. And then the peace of God, that is something that we should have for us to, yes, be at peace, di ba? Para hindi tayo na tatamaan or nasusway kung anuman yung mga, whatever, negative things that is occurring or happening around us. Patience, that's something I believe most of us, if not all, most of us would really struggle with. Tama ba? Tingnan nyo nga katabi nyo, mukha bang pasensyoso yan? Or kailangan ng maraming pasensya. And then Mark followed it up with kindness and goodness, where he defined kindness simply as a tender concern, tama ba? Resulting in an action that would benefit an individual, right? And then goodness, when he talked about it, he simply wanted to share with you about moral excellence, right? So I would just like to put it in a manner when you talk about goodness based on his message, it is something that you will have to just do what is right no matter what. And then last week, I think Tito John Salalima shared with you about faithfulness, where he talked about the steadfast, of being steadfast. Kasi title niya, ano yan? Be faithful. Finish well. So it would not really matter as to how good or how well one would start, right? And so he shared with that, ang kailangan talaga natin is how we would finish well. And so with that, tonight, may assignment here, okay, that was given to me. So talk about gentleness. And I like, because prior to coming here, I wasn't aware that there will be a testimony. I was so blessed with it. Thank you, Sister Joy. Okay, for that wonderful sharing of testimony. And then, I'm not sure when you will wrap this up when you talk about self-control. So right now, sige, before I even begin, natutuwa ako sa pagiging responsive ng Big South. So can we just recite this again before I even dive into the text? So, but the fruit of the Spirit is? Nyam, 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 nyam. Parang nagkahabulan na. Anyway, so parang karera. I know, deep in your hearts, alam naman natin to. We know what this, not fruits, okay? We know what the aspects or the characteristic of the fruit of the Spirit is. So, eto yan. So, tonight, sige, tuloy ko na yan with gentleness as we will be talking about this aspect of the Spirit. And so tonight, as I think John B. and May already alluded earlier, what the title of the message would be. I'm really having a hard time as to how to come up with the title because there are so many things that I would like to share regarding gentleness. And so with this, I would just like to make this. I hope we can all make this as a prayer of our own that at the end of the service, we will learn to be gentle, and not just with that, be more specific, as to learn to be gentle like Jesus. Can you say that to your, can you gently say that to the person next to you? Learn to be gentle like Jesus. I think kayang-kaya nyo na yun. So can we close this out na, Mark? No. Ayan, so sige, before we continue, can we just can we join our hearts as we commit this time to the Lord in prayer? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time that you have allowed us once again to gather here. I thank you for my brothers and sisters here in Big South Alabang. Lord, may you just fill all of us with the Holy Spirit that we need, that we may just understand and comprehend whatever it is that you have in store for us tonight. And so I just want to thank you for the privilege of sharing your word to your people. Will you just not allow your servant to speak anything that would not edify your people tonight? And we just commit to you the rest of our time together. This we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so before anything else, gentleness, how do we define it? Because if you will look at the definition of gentleness, I'm not sure. Ngayon naman, di ba, sobrang common sa atin ng internet. So if you will just Google in your phones what gentleness would be, sobrang dami nating makikita ang definition. But I would like to go with this definition for tonight, for the sake of our discussion tonight. But the rest, I will have to leave that to your breakout group discussions later. Okay? So gentleness, let me read, is the character that will show calmness, personal care, tenderness, and the love of Christ in meeting the needs of others. It is more than just a personality. Uy, si ano mukhang gentle. Tulad nun, uy, epitome ng gentleness. So parang gano'n. It's more than that. But yeah, I was blessed to hear that. And actually, I would go with John V. I would agree with it then. I've known this guy for quite some time. So, gentleness, mas gusto ko i-highlight yung word dyan na calmness. Okay? So, when you talk about gentleness, when, I don't know, may naisip ba kayong salita when you hear the word, as in, kumbaga, gentle, ano ba yung may naririnig or naisip ba tayo? Bukod sa banayad. English. Sige, kahit Tagalog. Ano bang banayad? Gentle. Gentle. Hindi, joke lang. So what do we think about? How about something? Or someone? Jenny? Oh, meron? Jenny? Yeah. Actually, pwede. Gentle Jenny. Pwede yan. So gentle Jenny. Yeah, so I don't know. Why am I asking this? Because when we talk about gentleness, like in the previous messages, there are actually some words that, you know, we just use them, but not really trying to go deeper into what it really means. Diba? Uy, ang bait nga ni ganito. Uy, ang buti ni ganito. But what's the difference of bait and buti, in a sense? Diba? So right now, mas gusto nating pag-aralan yan. So we'll just try to answer some of the questions, but I will not go all through this. As to the who, why, how, what, okay? So out of these four questions, we'll just ponder on the two. So let me just go quickly with the who and the why. I believe this is the sixth installment of this message. So kung hindi pa kayo convinced, I'll have to leave that to the breakout group leaders later. But pasadahan ko lang, who are supposed to be gentle? If you are here with us, for those who are joining for the first time, well, if you are someone who claims to follow Jesus Christ, I would like to submit to you, as the Bible says, that you are someone who is expected to manifest the spirit of gentleness. So I would just like to put it as simple as that, okay? So if you are a follower of Jesus Christ, then you are someone who is to be gentle. And as to the why, di ba? So bakit? Like what I said, if you are someone who is professing to follow Jesus Christ, then you are expected to be gentle. But I would like to dwell more on the what and the how. This will be a two-part message. Kanina, hindi ko alam yung time frame nyo dito. So I actually prepared 7 to 8 and 8 to 9. Biro lang. So I was kidding with Mark. Dalawang part ng message, but no, we'll go quickly about it. But as to the how will I become a gentle person? Alam na natin eh. Okay, so we've been talking about it, and I've been using that word. Okay, I know this person to be gentle. I know I'm someone who needs to be gentle. I would like to speak on that premise that you are someone who is already convinced, and you are aware that you need to be gentle. Okay, so ngayon, ang pag-uusapan natin, how? We'll dive into the text later with that. And as to the what will I be like? This is sort of a self-assessment test na lang. Okay, so titignan natin, since titignan natin mamaya as to how one must be gentle, ano naman? Will there be a difference? Title, your theme is themed as, or rather, your theme is walk different. So if you are someone who is gentle, then meron bang ibang makikita sa atin? How will, or rather, what will I be like if I manifest the spirit of gentleness in my life? So we'll look into this, okay? So I'll be sharing with you, ito, play of words na lang yan, but I would want to encourage all of us here as I would like to share the road to gentleness and the power of gentleness. We'll deal with the how, titignan natin ano ba yung dapat nating daanan. We'll talk about the road. And with the what, titignan natin what will I be like or ano yung pwede kong gawin once I manifest gentleness. Okay, so our main text for tonight will come, if you have your Bibles, and I believe most or all of you do, so we'll be coming from Matthew chapter 11, verses 28, 29, 30. And let me just read to you, come to me, all who, Jesus speaking, come to me, all who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Why? For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. I would just like to, kanina kasi as I was driving here, baka naumay yung mga kasama ko dito because paulit-ulit ko lang piniplay yung kanta. Meron ba ditong kapanahunan ni Basil Valdez? Huwag na kayo mag-task kamay. Okay, so if, kung at least yung mga tumawa, kilala nyo. Actually, I was just listening to his song, Lift Up Your Hands, kung alam nyo yun. The lyrics, or rather this passage, kasi ginamit doon. Okay, so of course, I will not sing that. But yun, check nyo na lang sa Apple Music or sa Spotify if you want. Lift Up Your Hands by Basil Valdez. Kasi I've been hearing that ever since I was a child. I was a kid. For some reason, okay? And so, nung binabasa ko to, sabi ko, this is quite common actually. I don't know if you will agree with me. This is quite common to many of us. But what is the context ba? Ano ba yung nangyayari dito with this passage or with this account in the Bible, in when Matthew wrote this. So balikan lang natin, if you will go back to the first verse of this same chapter, you will see there that it says when Jesus finished giving instructions to the 12 disciples, he then departed and started to preach and teach in their cities. Okay, so nagtuturo si Jesus, city to city, town to town, I don't know. Kung saan man yan, make our own research. The Bible scholars would actually say that it is somewhere in the cities of Galilee. But tonight, let's just focus on the main thing and tignan natin siya, konti-konti. Okay, so come to me, all who are weary and heavy laden. What do we mean by this? Sipin nyo lang. Sige, some of you might be actually hearing this, di ba? Sunday after Sunday or even in your quiet time. But sino ba yung kausap? That's actually the first question I had when I was reviewing this text. Who is Jesus actually pertaining or rather inviting dito sa passage na to? Come to me. Sino sabi dyan? All who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. What do we mean, or what does Jesus mean when he's talking about those who are weary and heavy laden? So ito ba yung mga as in mabigat na, ano ba, mga bag nyo ngayon, mabigat, nag-grocery ka, mabigat, should you come to Jesus Christ kapag ganong nabibigatan tayo? I don't know. Okay, but this context nito kasi, if you will go forward tayo sa Matthew 23, is it here? Yeah. They tie up, let me read, they tie up heavy burdens, they pertaining to the Pharisees, okay? And lay them on men's shoulders, but they themselves are unwilling to move them with so much as a finger. What's happening? Some of us may not be getting this. Actually, Jesus is pertaining to the weary, and or rather the heavy laden, as the ones that is being put unto by the Pharisees to the people. Because during that time, actually, yung ginagawa niya doon is somewhat like the Pharisees are just giving this, you know, the laws, the, what we call the Pharisaic law. They've been burdening these people, but really, they are the ones who are not doing this. So yung mga tao, kaya pala niya ini-invite, come to me, those who are weary and heavy laden. Sobrang nabibigatan sila. They need to follow these laws. And even dyan, yung mga tinutukoy dyan na laws, we know the Mosaic law. Ilan yun? Mosaic law, we have 10, okay? So yung Moses, or rather, just the 10 commandments. But actually, the Pharisees, just the term, sorry. So the Mosaic law, they actually even codified it, di ba? So about, I don't know, 600 more commandments, or rather, 600 laws. They broke it down to 360 prohibitions and another 250 commandments. So why am I saying that? It's just the numbers. But the point is, ba, these people are actually living under the quote-unquote law that would just strangle them. Okay? Nalilito na sila. How can we get saved? The main passage natin dito, Galatians 5, I believe the previous speakers have alluded to that. That they are actually living under a legalistic way of life, right? So sobrang nahihirapan sila. That's why Paul had to write a letter to the believers in Galatia. Nalilito na sila. How can really we get saved? Or how can one really get saved? So in here, yung context natin dyan, when Jesus is actually referring to these words, come to me, it is a very personal thing. Okay, that's what I like here. You can really see God or Jesus being so personal of a God. He says, come to me. He did not say, come to any religious group, come to any group, come to any whatever ordinance or ministry, but he says there, come to me. Diba? So we can actually relate to that right now. Pag binasa niyo yan, something like come to CCF or come to this congregation, come to this church. It's not something like that. What we need to understand here is the first and foremost important that we are to have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Okay, so we're talking about the road to gentleness, so we will need to break it down para malinaw tayo. Okay, so that's actually the first thing that I would want to share tonight, is that we are to respond to the invitation of Jesus. So let's proceed. Okay, so as we respond to the invitation of Jesus, next verse. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. Pause muna tayo dyan, okay? Let's focus on this set of words. When Jesus said to take my yoke upon you, familiar tayo sa yoke? Sino dito ang mahilig sa sunny side up? Tsaka, hindi, joke lang. Iba yung yoke na egg yoke. Iba yun, okay? So, yoke, if you are not familiar, I know, most of you know this, but yoke, kita ba dyan? Lakihan natin. Yan. So, yung yoke na sinasabi dyan, that is actually a wooden masterpiece. Okay? Na nilalagay sa animals in... as they will just flow sa mga whatever assignments na binibigay sa kanila, in a sense. Okay, so let's just make it clear. Ito yung yoke. So the illustration there would be, Jesus is telling us to take His yoke upon us. So I would want us to understand first that in actuality, right now, we are actually having our own yokes. Okay, so let's be clear with that. We have currently our own yokes and plus the burdens that is being put unto us by the people around us. In the context of this passage, kanina, yung mga tao, meron silang yoke, and then yung Pharisees, sobrang bigat nung binibigay sa kanila. That's why He is asking them to come to Him. Okay? And so with that, sabi niya, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. I believe Mark and kindness, nadaanan niyo yung passage na yun, for my yoke is easy, when he defined yung kindness, something to deal with the word easy. Right? So, I just thought about it, and when you are someone or you are kind to someone, isn't it that you are making life easy for that someone, right? So in the same manner as God being a gentle God as He is, the same way, my yoke is easy. He wants us to be freed from this, whatever legalities, okay, that the previous lawmakers are actually giving these people. So ngayon din, meron din tayong mga, later, we will talk about that, okay? But for now, I just like to make an emphasis on that. When Jesus tells us to take His yoke upon us first, we would actually need to make this move, okay? So, by the way, let me share in 1 John chapter 5, verse 3, ito pala yun, this is what will prove that the yoke of God is not burdensome, okay? Sinabi na dyan, His commandments and His rather, that we keep His commandments and His commandments are not burdensome. Because some of us, we may be, I don't know, makapilosopo tayo dito. When I received Christ, by the time that I started following Jesus Christ, it really took a toll on me. Ang hirap eh. I need to follow this thing. I need to abide by this. I need to follow this. I need to do what these people would tell me. Ang hirap. So it's becoming of a burden. I believe many of us, tama ba? I don't know, I'm communicating with you guys. When the time that we realize that we need to do something for God, it is somehow, some way, shape, or form, it's becoming a burden to us. But looking at this verse, I was again refreshed and encouraged na hindi pala dapat ganun. Why? Because, see there, the commandments of God, it's not burdensome. So if it is becoming of a burden to us in a negative manner, then I think we need talk about something else. Okay? So I would want to leave that to you. Pag-isipan natin yun. But my point here is that based on the passage, very clear yun that Jesus wants us to take His yoke because His yoke is easy and His burden is light. Okay? So next thing that I would want us to take in this road You can't just receive the yoke of Jesus Christ when you will not release yours. Okay, so we need to release our current burdens. Okay, and then what we need to do is then to obey what He says to receive His yoke. And it will make it easy for us, according to that passage. Okay, as to how we define easy, I'll leave that to your breakout groups later. And let's move on. Let's take the remaining sets of words. Okay, learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Talking about this passage, okay, so learn from me, for I am gentle in heart, and you will find rest. Singles, sige, sagot tayo yes or no lang. Sino dito gusto ng rest? Wala. I think almost everyone, most of us, I want to say all of us, would actually want some rest. Diba? Do you want to rest yung tahimik in peace? No, just kidding. So, I know we would want to rest. But seriously, I actually use that word, that I would want to rest in peace at times. Walang maingay. Literal translation, okay? But for us, diba? So, we are commanded to come to Jesus first, right? And then we are to take His yoke. And dito, what are we supposed to do? We are to learn from Jesus Christ. Learn what? There are so many things that we can learn from Jesus Christ, diba? But in this passage, it amazes me how He actually described Himself as someone who is gentle and humble in heart. Question, can someone be gentle without being humble? You can just think about it, but oh nga, can someone be gentle without being humble? How do we define, diba, kanina gentleness pinag-uusapin? You need to become. And you need to just let go of whatever your preference may be and just think about the need of that other person, right? And so if we will just try to be gentle without being humble, again, proud, according to Galatians 6, diba, it actually defines that proud would make us think that we are something when we really are nothing. So talaga isipin natin, it's all about me, it's all about me, it's all about me. So do you think we can afford to be gentle if we are not humble? I would want us to see the direct relationship of gentleness and humility here. So if we will not learn to humble ourselves before God, even before people, then we will not be able to manifest a gentle spirit. Diba? So, si gentle wife, diba? Tama ba? Would you agree? Right? So I hope we are clear with that. So tignan natin. Here, we're talking about the road to gentleness. And I'm trying to share with you how it is. First, we are to respond to Jesus' invitation. We are to release our burdens and receive His yoke. And dito naman, I would want us to make, or rather come up with that realization that we actually need Him. Because apart from Him, I submit to you, some of us would actually just try to be gentle, try to be manifest whatever spirit that the Lord would expect of us without actually or no longer depending on Him. You be the judge, but are there times right now, you just think about it, when we try to manifest this spirit of gentleness, but we are actually not depending on God. We know, kaya natin. Ako, I was actually inborn daw ako, may nagsabi. Inborn ako, gentle na ako eh. Sa ospital pa lang nga, yung doktor, napaka-gentleman ko sa doktor nung umiyak ako. So parang, I don't know. So, but seriously speaking, sorry about that. So, meron daw, na bata pa lang, gentle niya na. Eh, di ba most, I think on Sundays, naririnig natin yun, that you would not teach, or you would not need to teach a child in order for him to make away-away, di ba? Yung konyo, no? So, make away or makipag-away, di ba? Kasi natural yan sa atin. As long as we are here in this flesh, we are actually people who would just commit sin without us realizing that we need someone to save us from that struggle, as I would say, di ba? So it's very important for us to realize that we need Jesus Christ. Okay, so this is actually a reminder and an encouragement to all of us. As we try to learn to be gentle and manifest this spirit of gentleness in and through us, we would need to depend on that someone who is the lone source of a gentle spirit. And that is none other than Jesus Christ Himself, as He Himself is a gentle and a humble God. Right? So dito, para lang tignan natin, so like what I said kanina, very personal. Again, I like how, I just like to leave that to you, basahin yan even later, before you sleep maybe. just try to encourage yourself. This passage would just show you how personal Jesus Christ is when he tells you to come to him, and you will just have to really respond in his invitation. And when he tells us to take his yoke upon him, first we would need to release. And then that's the only time that we will be able to receive his yoke, because his yoke is easy and his burden is light. And then with that, as we learn from him, we will be, or rather, that's the stage where we would need to come to a realization that we can never, never try or even be gentle without his leading. Okay? So this is the road to gentleness that I would want to share with you. So we're talking about learn to be gentle like Jesus. Come on, sige. Sabihin niyo ulit sa katabi niyo, mas gentle. Learn to be gentle like Jesus. Ano yun? Okay, sige. Tuloy natin. So for the second part of our message tonight, I'll be sharing with you the power of gentleness. Given that you are someone who already responded to the calling of God for you to manifest gentleness, tignan naman natin, ano ba yung pwede nating magawa when we are manifesting this gentle spirit? This will be very practical. Actually, marami pa yan. These are suggestive or prescriptive, okay, I would say. So first thing that we can do is we will be able to pacify anger. What do we mean by pacify? Sino dito gumamit dati ng pacifier? I think meron, di ba? So when there will be actually babies who would just cry and cry, what will you do? Uso pa ba ito ngayon? I don't know eh. Sino ba? If you are taking care of babies, di ba? So you will need to just make pasak. Ano ba yan? Pasak sa bibig nila. Yung pacifier that they would just keep silent. Okay, so in the same way, what are we talking about when we are saying that as people or as a child of God who is manifesting a gentle spirit, we can pacify anger? In Proverbs 15, verse 1, it says, can we all read this? A gentle answer. A gentle answer turns away wrath. Ano ba yung wrath na yan? Ang Tagalog niyan? Daga. I hear, sino nagsabi ng daga? Wrath, okay, but a harsh word, anger na lang. O sige, away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. I remember just a very quick story kasi when there is this seller and basta yung bumibili. Okay, so he is selling a newspaper on the banquets, but long story short, merong siyang customer na sobrang irritable, and every time that person would just buy a newspaper from him, you know, yung makita nyo palang ayaw nyo nang tignan. You get what I mean? Diba? But this person is just actually someone who is so gentle that whenever he would relate to that person, he would just smile. He would just, as if the person is a gentle person as well, if you're getting what I'm talking about. Okay, so suddenly, one day, the person approached this gentle person, okay, yung nagtitinda, na lagi nakangiti lang, ganyan. Tinanong siya, how is it that you are able to maintain that composure? Eh, sa totoo lang, ako nga ayokong bentahan yung taong yun, eh, diba? But I like what he said, and I just like to coin it with this, okay? So I actually could not determine how others will act, but I can determine how I will react. Get this? What do we mean by this? Because some of us, okay, we are actually dependent on the people around us. Eh hindi, lagi ako sinisigawan eh. When he talks to me, it's as if he is someone so high, someone so mighty. So ako, sasabay lang din ako. Kumbaga, level-level tayo, di ba? Patawaran tayo. That's what some of us would actually say, if you can relate, di ba? So I don't know about you. In your families, in your office work, we might be doing something like this when we would just choose to be harsh rather than be gentle. Why? Because the other party is actually harsh towards us. But is it right? Well, that's a rhetorical question that's for you and me to discover. It's very clear that we are to gently answer the people around us. This is about a decision, okay? It would not be nice, actually. Mahirap siya, yes. Diba? I know the feeling that you would just want to answer back, but we are not to do so. Why? Because that is what is expected of us. Sounds fair, diba? So, with that, ito yung warning naman. Kasi if you are someone na talagang, you know, Talagang sagot lang ng sagot because of the people that is happening around you. This is a concern for all of us, for the mouth speaks out of that which fills the heart. If you are that someone, probably the question for all of us is what is filling our heart right now? If konting may makita tayo, sobrang irritable tayo, or we would just, you know, try to lash out at people, I don't know, even curse them behind their backs, so we would really have a hard time dealing with them. But the question is, other than focusing on that person, the question is, what is filling our heart? Because regardless of how that person would behave, if we are filled with the Spirit, then we could just actually smile at them. Think about a circumstance in your life that you are so heavy laden. Diba? Those are the times that you really become weary. That's a cause and effect. When you are so heavy laden, that's the cause. In effect, you will be weary. And you could not actually have rest in Jesus. So let's think about that. As we proceed, talking about the power of gentleness able to pacify anger, how about the next one? The power of gentleness, we would actually have the power to persuade people. Persuade who? Just two groups of people that I would want to share here. Probably the authorities, if you are working, you have an employer, and the other is to sharing to the people who have yet to establish a relationship with Jesus Christ. It says here, by forbearance, a ruler may be persuaded, and a soft tongue breaks the bone. By forbearance, a ruler may. Well, I would like to highlight the word may. Will that word connote you certainty? Or may guarantee ba that you will be able to persuade? Actually, wala, di ba? So that's actually where our rationalization would come in. Eh, hindi naman eh. Baka I need to be harsh at him. That I need to be able to persuade him. What if, di ba? Tayo, may role naman tayo dyan. I don't know if you have experiences with your bosses, if you're working in an office or even dealing with your clients. Paano lang kapag inutusan tayo something that would go against your conviction as a believer of Jesus Christ? How will we deal with that? Could we still stay gentle as we can? Or, di na, sasagutin natin. For example, Karen, if you will, you are asked, for example, to just answer a call. I don't know if you've experienced this. Answer a call to your boss, sabihin mo na wala ako. But she is there. Karen, can you pick up that phone and tell that person, I don't want to talk to her, tell her wala ako. How will we respond? If she would not do that, that may cost her job. Talking about persuasion, so could she just be so harsh towards that person? I don't know, she'll answer, sorry ma'am, I just can't do that, you know, because the Bible says that all liars will be sent to the lake that burns with fire and brimstone, and that is the second death. I don't know, pwede ba niyang sagutin ng ganun lang? But seriously, I don't know, I'm just exaggerating this, but my point is, how do we deal during those times that we will be caught under such circumstances? I've experienced this, and maybe something like, parang, well, first and foremost, I don't know about your conviction, but as for me, I would not answer that. Okay, but ma'am, can we talk about it later or even now? I really can't do it. So if that would seem disrespectful to you, I think I'd just like to say something and share something with you. Di ba naman pwedeng kailangang sermonan agad or preachan mo, di ba? So, but seriously, some of us, well, we know, I don't know, I know some people who would just tend to just, alam mo yun, parang gusto ihampas yung Bible sa kanila. Seriously, in that manner. So, tignan natin. The wise in heart will be called understanding. Sweetness of speech increases persuasiveness. I just want to be quick with this, diba? Talking about, sino ba dito, wag na magtaas? Those who are single but in a relationship. Okay, so, you probably would want, gusto nyo ba ng sweet? Yung kapag kinukumbinsi kayo, diba? Or even the singles, diba? Ang tawa-tawa, kinikilig iba dyan. Okay, so we'll probably want na papasama sa inyo and then sobrang harsh. Diba? Ladies, would you want that? A man na ipo-persuade kayo, trying to get you to go somewhere and then, wala, walang sweetness talagang. Sweetheart, sumama naman ako, punta tayo sa SM. Parang ganun lang. As in, wala. Parang sweet, diba? Parang, magagawin ka ba? Seriously, diba? As singles, we should be talking about that. But some of us, how are we dealing with it? Sabi dito, sweetness of speech increases persuasiveness. Diba? We're just talking about these practical things in life, but some of us would actually fail in these categories. So how are we dealing with gentleness in this regard? With regards to 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 24-26, I would like to share something here, but I'll try again. The Lord's bondservant must not be quarrelsome, patient when wronged. Those who are in opposition, I would like to highlight that word. Yung mga nasa opposition. And it goes on to say, if perhaps God may grant them repentance leading to the knowledge of the truth, and they may come to their senses from the snare of the devil, having held captive to do his will. I actually had an encounter, I think this was December 2015, just to be quick about it, I had an encounter with someone who is really hating God. Okay, so naligaw siya, not really naligaw, I believe that was a divine appointment in CCF Las Piñas. But long story short, he really hated God, and he was cursing at him, I hate your God, blah, 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 and all. And then, okay, I'll just fast forward, I won't be detailed about it. After that meeting, I was really just praying for him, and I got his name from the admin, so I stalked his Facebook, and I just prayed for him, seriously. And then, I think 2 or 3 weeks, I saw him post something that he's attending a service in CCF Center, so I don't know about that. So, how can I judge this person? Parang weeks ago lang kausap ko, halos sapakin na nga ako eh. Because I'm trying to be as, yeah, seriously, I'm trying to share with him something as gentle as I can, but he would just really repel everything that I would say. So with that, again, fast forward, I actually bumped into him. I would not say which CCF hub or satellite, but he was being discipled na by a friend of mine. So wow, I just praise God for that person, and if ever I would see him somewhere around the globe, probably I just want to give him a brotherly hug, praising God for what happened, and just probably sit down with him. Can we praise God for that? Yeah, but you can just imagine during that encounter, it's not about me, but it's about God. If we would just, di ba, talagang sobrang kinokontra niya yung Bible, and I just, sabi niya nga sa akin, I just want to prove every pastor, everything that the pastors teach, his teaching is wrong. Yung mga ganun talaga, yung mga linya niya. So, as in lahat. And so far, tama naman daw siya. So, up until God actually led him to come to his senses. Okay? So, we can just praise God for that. So, I hope we would just continue to deal with these kinds of people still with gentleness in our hearts. Sanctify Christ as Lord in our hearts, always being ready to make a defense. So, huwag kayong bibili ng shield na ganyan. Okay? So, make a defense to everyone who asks you to give an account for the hope that is in you yet with gentleness and reverence. So I hope that would really encourage us to do not what we want, but do what is right. Okay? This would probably be the most important that I will be sharing tonight. So just like to go about it. And ito yun. Okay? So we talked about the power of gentleness, being able to pacify anger, persuade people, and lastly, when you are someone who is gentle, you will be someone who is promoting Christ-likeness. Isn't this one of the, I would say, the ultimate goals of a Christian? Diba? So, as believers, we are to, kumbaga, imo-model talaga natin, who Christ is in our life. So, we may be attending whatever fellowship or gatherings, but are we really emulating Jesus Christ? So, that is something that I would want us to hold on to as we go about this message tonight. And just quickly, gusto ko lang ibalik yung main passage natin kanina in Matthew 11, 28-30. We're all in agreement when Jesus said that He is a God who is gentle and humble in heart, right? So kung tayo, we are genuine believers of the Lord Jesus Christ, I believe tayo din mismo, we would want, don't we want to be described as someone who is, si Rocky, gentle and humble yan eh. Diba? So parang ayaw niyang pumayag. Siya mismo eh. Siya mismo ayaw niya pumayag. So whoever, diba, amongst us, isn't that would be a good and nice description for us. So think about it. So gusto ko lang yun i-encourage sa ating lahat and to for us to really be reminded as to how we should be living as believers of Jesus Christ. And you know naman that we are commanded to be evident, di ba? Kumbaga, ikalat talaga natin yan, dapat malaman natin. Yung mga nagre-react, Okay? Okay na yun, okay. So whatever happened, mamaya nyo na pag-usapan yan. But let your gentle spirit, Paul is saying, be known to all men. So my concern here is, baka, for example, in this context, or rather, in this setup, iba sa atin, pa-gentle-gentle kuno, because we are with our fellow believers. We are with your D groups, di ba? Or kasama nyo yung mga tao who are knowledgeable about the faith that you declare. But how about when we are out there? Nasa bahay tayo, it so happened, for example, it's just you who has a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Diba? So it would be harder, and that is the real battleground for us. In our offices, hindi naman nila alam, ah, kailangan ba natin i-manifest yung gentle spirit na yan? No. So sa atin, parang sabak lang tayo ng sabak. We will just lash at them, and even, like what I said earlier, le-level tayo sa kanila because we're in the office. Eh. So parang, I need to prove something, I need to prove my point, so I would just shout back at this people or even with my clients, with my colleagues. I need to prove something. So we should not be like that because as we are commanded to let our gentle spirit be known to all men. Okay, not just to some, but to all men. So with that, just a quick recap as what I've shared with you tonight. The road to gentleness and the power of gentleness. And very quick, we are responding. First and foremost that I shared with you earlier is for us to respond to Jesus' invitation when he said that we are to come to him. And when he said that we are to take his yoke upon us, we are to release first our burdens that we may be able to take and receive his yoke as well. And so lastly, when he said that we would need to learn from him, that is the time that we would need to be fully aware of the fact that we need Jesus Christ in order for us to be able to manifest a gentle spirit. Okay, and with the power of gentleness, pag-usapan natin later kung gusto niyo pang pag-usapan, okay? So we are people who would have that ability to be able to pacify anger, to persuade people, and most importantly, to promote Christ-likeness. Okay ba yan? And sagutin niyo yung si white man. Okay, so, well, I don't know if kilala ba to dito. I'd really like to use this illustration as I close this out. So, nakikita ba ang dilim yata eh? Patayin natin ilaw? No, just kidding. But, yeah, sorry. Kita ba? Movie tayo. But seriously, so if you don't know, this is from the TV series called Arrow. I love to use this illustration. If you've watched this, this is the ending of the second season. Okay, so if you don't know them, this is, ito yung alter ego nila, si Green Arrow, si Oliver Queen, and si Slade Wilson, Deathstroke. So why am I sharing this? Okay, I would just like to share with you what happened here in this scenario, in this episode, because listen to this, just a very quick background, kasi yung nangyayari dyan is si Oliver, okay, yung mom niya pinatay ni Slade Wilson, if you know that, si ni Deathstroke. So, in a sense, Oliver being a vigilante, he's a killer. Background lang, okay? He could easily kill this guy. And he is actually provoking Oliver Queen or the Arrow to just kill him. But Oliver would not want to. Because in this part of the series, he actually had a change of heart. He just wants to capture the bad guys without killing them. Okay? And so with this is how the conversation went about during that time. Okay? So sinabi ni Slade Wilson, "That's your weakness, kid. Listen to these words. You don't have the guts to kill me." How did Oliver respond? Well, Oliver Queen responded, and he said this, "No, I have the strength to let you live." If you are getting what I'm trying to convey here, okay? So I really love what took place here. Oliver, as someone, can turn back on the lights. Nakikita nyo dito, yung paggawa ng tama, doing what is right, one actually would see it as a weakness and the other would see it as a strength. So in likewise manner, pinag-uusapan natin dito gentleness. In the outside realm, if you are someone who is gentle talaga, diba, baka iba yung maging tingin sa atin. So that's why I'm trying to give this illustration for us to be able to connect. That you would need to do what is right, not necessarily what you want. Because as people of God, we are actually trying to promote being like Christ. And so as I close with this verse in Romans 5:8, God demonstrates his own love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, what did he do? Christ died for us. What about this? Oliver, well, in his parents, buhay ni Slade, ni Deathstroke. But here, Jesus, let's go back to our main subject. Let's not focus on Oliver Queen, but on Jesus Christ. Anong ginawa niya? Hindi niya lang in-spare buhay natin. As sinners, what did he do? To us, being sinners, he actually even chose to die for us. So that is my sentiment actually here. For all of us, we're still having that struggle to manifest a gentle spirit. But if we can just go back to what Jesus Christ has done for us on the cross, well, I would say that we would really have no need for gatherings like this. Even Mark would not need to prepare such messages. Kung talagang maiintindihan natin what really took place almost 2,000 years ago when Jesus died for you and Jesus died for the person beside you. So I would want us to really ponder on this historic act that God has done for us. As I leave you with that, again, let me remind that even though that the world would actually see you as weak in their eyes, remember that in the eyes of God, you are someone who is spiritually strong. So I'd want to summarize everything that we've had with this saying that a gentle person may seem weak in the eyes of men, but spiritually strong in the eyes of God. Do you agree with this? Well, if we do, I hope as we try to walk different, living in the Spirit, my prayer is that as we leave this place, we will really have that hunger and that desire to just genuinely learn to be gentle like Jesus Christ. So for the last time, as we close this out, can you just tell the person next to you, learn to be gentle like Jesus. Yan. Sobrang gentle na natin by this time. Okay. Okay. So shall we pray? Can I ask everyone to stand as we all join our hearts with a word of prayer? Dear Heavenly Father, I'd like to thank you for this time that you have allowed us to just study your word. And Father, we just thank you how rich your word is, that we can just freely study it and learn from it. Learn how to be gentle like your son, Jesus Christ. And so Father, as I pray for my brothers and sisters here who may be struggling in this sort of regard, who are really having that hard of a time to just be gentle towards the people around them, be it our parents, our colleagues, even some of our clients in our businesses, in whatever aspect of life that we are in. Lord, may we just continue and boldly make that decision that no matter what, we will choose to be gentle because you and your son is a gentle and humble God. So Lord Jesus, I just want to thank you for this privilege that we are able to talk about this truth, and may this not just remain in our minds, but may this truth just sink deep down into our hearts, that it may not remain as a mere knowledge, but this may be used as a way for us to be transformed, to be more like your son, Jesus Christ. So we just praise you, Father, and we thank you for everything, and we commit to you the rest and the balance of this night. Lord Jesus, we thank you, and this we ask in your most mighty, in your sweetest, and your most gentle name. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And everybody say, amen. Thank you, and God bless you.